So the first thing that we do after creating a brand is that we have to show people of homepage. Yeah, so once we... to do it from there, the aspect ratio. Yeah. The first slide, please. Yeah, so after creating a brand, the most important thing is you have to showcase that brand. If I create a good logo, I make effort to copyright it, I can't just keep it at my clinic. I need to show people. The most important thing that I would say in website development is, do I need a website? Yes, certainly yes. Because when you are in your clinic, there is a patient who is like maybe 100 kilometers away. How would he know what practice you do? What are your qualifications? Nowadays, we have patients coming to us. Doctor, what are your qualifications? How many surgeries you have done? We have, all of us, we have these kind of patients coming to you. What if I don't have to answer them and perhaps display something of my work on the website that I have? Nowadays, I have displayed everything on a website and I tell my patients, why don't you go back on my website and you have a set of instructions to be followed after the cataract surgery or for lid hygiene on a blepharitis. Everything is mentioned on the website. So they are also kind of, you know, they connect to you, they go and visit your website. So yes, in nowadays, we need to have a good website and an updated website. I'll be speaking about that. Why we need a website? Because yeah, everyone from every age group is on phone, is on a tab, is on a laptop nowadays. So even if you have a fever, what you sometimes go to another place, like I shifted from Bombay to Pune, if you have to search something, we say dentist near us or an eye surgeon near us. So once you, somebody clicks that, the organic search happens. Over the period of time, your search comes up and you will need a website for people to know what are your timings, what are your this thing. There are other platforms showing that, like example, there are Practo, there are Just Dial showing that. But then what you basically have to target is your own website to come up over the period of time. The scope of this presentation will be the importance of having a website, basic of website management. So once you decide that I have to do a website, what all things you need to work on, what is the content writing, the designing part of it, and at the end of it, some fun facts. Importance of website, yes, you're sleeping in your home at around 1 a.m. in the night and somebody wants to know that, you know, he wants to undergo LASIK next week, what should we do? So he goes on net, he searches for it, he goes to your website. So basically you are sleeping, somebody else is working for you. For that you need a website, you need an online presence. You have to put your information that you know and you have to personalize it. You cannot just copy paste some of the post LASIK instructions, copy that and put it on your website. No, you have to customize it the way you're going to speak when the patient comes to you. It has a lot of credibility once you have a website. So even if people coming to you for some other work, you to ask them, do you have a website so that I can go back and see your work, how much work you are doing. For it's a simple example, like an event manager for a conference. We ask them, do you have a website? So we see the credibility of that particular person, whether he has a good website or he doesn't have a good website. It cuts the cost. You have a larger market to work on. Advertising, yes, and every one of your competitor has a good website, so it's mandatory that we have a good website, and it's a lot of growth opportunity there can be on website communication with the patient as well. So in short, I want to inform, I want to educate the patient, and I want to persuade them. So whatever information they are looking for a cataract surgery. I want to inform them about the cataract surgery and also attract them towards you, the services that you provide. The basic thing that everybody is going to ask you is, what is a website domain and what is a website hosting? These are two different things. Now, my clinic is a NeoVision Eye Care. Okay, so that is something, once the moment I decided my clinic's name is NeoVision Eye Care, then I go on searching the name for online presence. So that's where the domain comes into play, because that will be your address. in the world of web, everywhere you need to have one particular address, and that what is a website domain is. And to showcase your web address, what is there in that, you need a website hosting. So there are two different things. Website domain and website hosting is two different things. Website domain is just your name and you have to pay for it annually, trust me. And then website hosting is a different thing. There to how manage your website is absolutely altogether thing, altogether different thing. So where to get a domain name from? So what, when I had this thing, and also these, all of these, they kind of, you know, check you again and again. So if I want to go for and search for a name, so if I wanted a neovisionicare.com and I just shut it down, ki ya chalo kal search karenge, tomorrow the rates will be higher. When you go from one domain registrar to another domain registrar, they know that you are searching for it, and then they will increase the price. If there are local people around it, they also track you. And then they will say, ki, sir, the cost is this much. So have some clear idea in your mind, this is a website you're going to go for, and fix a domain as quick as possible. The charges will be fairly less. There are domain registrars who do that for you. At the same time, they also offer a website hosting, or you can create another person who is close to you, who can, you can tell the content, ki, yaar, okay, I've got this award, put this image in my website. So home domain hosting can be done by another person as well. So to simplify, you have to register a domain name and sign up for a website hosting plan. You have to pay differently for both of them. Now there are some people who say ki hum dono kar lenge, and you give all the contract to him. Yes, but what I believe is at least the domain name, the domain credentials should be, the username and ID should be with you. Otherwise the people, they really don't share. I'm stuck up with a website hosting with some because he is not giving me the detailed plan of the website hosting. So ideally, both of the login details should be with you. Either a company, same company, or a different company like GoDaddy, it will do both of your things. The website hosting also, website domain also. Another person that people will come to you, sir, should I make a static website for you or should I make a dynamic website for you? Now, static website, our usual ophthalmologist should be absolutely enough. But if you have something like a Flipkart, Amazon, where the products come, products go, they track you of what you are searching and constantly upgrading. The moment you enter a page, click a page, kick a page, after 2 minutes, the content will differ. So that's a dynamic website for our ophthalmologist doctors. A static website is good enough because there's a lot of cost difference between the static and the dynamic website. So that's what we do. In a dynamic website, everything changes. The moment you go to a web server, they will have a protocol key. Okay, in that particular era, somebody searched for this, and then they'll show you that thing. Similar to whatever you see on Amazon and Flipkart or a Facebook is basically a dynamic website. For our ophthalmologist, a static website is good enough. So a web design obviously requires a lot and lot of things. It has to be a professional thing, then it has to be simple. So the most important thing that I always say is keep it absolutely simple. It has to have a lot of white areas. Your web page, whichever area is empty, is called as white areas. It too has to have a lot of white areas. Don't make it really crowded. Two most important aspects of the website, and both are very important. Content is important, but more important to that is the designing. Around 40% of the people, if they don't find the design really good, they might just shift to another website, despite your content being best of all other website. So apart from content designing, such because it's obviously a showcase that you're going to do of your services. So most common headings that we normally do is about services offer, know your doctor, gallery, article section and publication, frequently asked question, and contact us. So the major tabs should not be more than 7. It is said that if you have those major tabs more than 7, there is a high chances of the person dropping out. There are studies published on that also. The content should be crisp. It has to be in layman language. For example, if you're having a pediatric ophthalmology department, you can simply write kids eye checkup. So it has, the patient can relate to it, like an oculoplasty surgeon, you can just shift it to a plastic surgery of the eye. Something like that, so that the patient, it becomes very easy for them to assess and come to your website. Easily accessible in less than 3 clicks. Suppose if you're looking for a cataract, if I go to my website and it takes more than 3 clicks for me to reach to a cataract information that I am looking for, perhaps you're going to lose that 40% of times you're going to lose that particular person who's coming to your website. So website has to be something, this thing. So if I'm looking for an intraocular lenses, I have to have less than 3 clicks for the person to reach to that intraocular lenses. So that's very important. And obviously visual memory is more powerful than content. So images is the thing to go. So good design is an understandable, interesting, easy to use, uniform in look and feel. And from the visitor's point of view, what you see is what you want. They want it quickly. If they have LASIK in their mind, it has to be coming in the first 2 or 3 clicks when they are on your website. Something, content is important. Content alone will not work. If you have such full web page, perhaps not a good sign, because you know you'll just spend a lot of time in just thinking where to click and what to look for. It has to be very, and this is another example of a bad content and design. You don't want all this kind of thing when you open your web page. There's something called as Hicks law. The more choices that you give to an individual, the longer it will take to make a decision. Don't confuse the person who is coming to your website. You have to make it very simple. Whatever services that you want to highlight, you have to just highlight that and move ahead. Limit the form fields and stick to one goal per page. Now, out of this, I would say the last sentence is the most important thing. Even there are other platforms which say, ki, now if you don't have a website on your mobile friendly, perhaps it's better that you don't have your website. Everyone wants it on a phone nowadays. Everyone wants the information on a phone while traveling in the bus or anything. They don't have access to the laptop, and travel time is people utilize for these kind of research thing. So it has to be mobile friendly. You can't have a website which is not a mobile friendly. Images, the most important thing on the website, I would say ki images should show the goal of the product. For example, if you are working in you have a hospital in rural population, show the image of a rural population. You can't show a Western population with spectacle removal causing the LASIK. No, you have to have the images which relate to them and showing the goal very clearly. So that's one thing that I would say that and you can, obviously, the lenses that you're going to use, you can put their images, whatever is relevant to that, you can put. But it's very important that you update the images as per your recent achievements. So as Dr. Samita said very rightly, you have to update. So if you get an award, send that image to your website hosting person. Tell him to update it. An updated website will have more views also, and people will get to know also that the recent things that you have achieved. Clear navigation, limit the items to menu less than 7. So this is how it should be, as clean as this, a good image, focus your eyes, like limited words that you keep, and let the people go on whatever services they want to. This is their hospitals, and you have to have this make an appointment kind of thing, so the patients can directly enter their details in a flash of second. The person from your hospital can call up, or it comes to your email, you reply to that particular email, and that's a very important thing. This is my website where I have a different article section. So articles, whatever I have written in different publications or in the newspapers, I have a link to that, and it's for the patients. So I make sure that even any articles that I'm writing anywhere in a layman language or for newspapers, I put it here so that patients can go and see. And videos. So now if I'm presenting here, for example, so this is an AIOC platform. Maybe a month or later, you will have that AIOC presentation coming on the YouTube. Make a link of that. Make sure you project over your website so that the people know that you have done so many presentations. Whatever AIOC presentations that has been done in the past, make sure you have a link of that onto your website. That will make patients understand about your contribution also towards the society and how expert you are. So all the video links, I have some surgeons who record their surgeries and they have their YouTube channels. So what I tell them is to link that particular thing on your website as well. So they click it here and they go to your YouTube video. So that's very important that to have that kind of thing. I have to emphasize the mobile friendliness. The last thing is that why should I update my website? So just like a website, digital marketing and SEO, which will be covered later, it has to be refreshed. So if I have done a website and I've left it, it won't come up on an organic search over the period of time unless I'm updating it. So it's really important, small updates, layman terms updates, but then you have to kind of keep on updating your website, because that otherwise your search will not come up on the search engine optimization. If I have one more minute, I'll just show you about this. There's no internet connection here. I tried that. So accessibility issue. So people, around 20 to 30% of the people can be visually or disabled or something. So you have to have these kind of things. There are screen enhancers. So for this particular hospital which I work for has that particular accessibility issue. If you want that entire web page to come in the form of sound, it can happen. If you want that one particular section to be spoken up by the software, it does. You can enlarge it, you can change the contrast, you can change the color combination. Everything can be done on the website. If at all you reach to that stage where the people coming to you to your website are visually or other forms specially abled, then perhaps you can have this accessibility changes as well. So I will just conclude with some fun facts. Increasing a website loading page can prevent a loss of 7% of the possible conversation. So loading website, if it doesn't, it takes more than 5 to 7 seconds, perhaps you're gonna lose that particular person. 38% of the patients will stop engaging with the website if the content or the layout is unattractive, as I said. 48% of the people cited a website design is the number one factor of determining the credibility of the business. 47% of the people accept a web page to load in less than 2 seconds. So if you have larger web images, then that will take a lot of time. And 48% of the users says if the business website is not mobile friendly, they'll simply take it as an indication that a business simply doesn't exist. So some of the references, and thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you. I think I just want to make 2 points. One he's already made, and I'm going to again reiterate it. There is no better value on your website than genuine photographs of people from your region. The number of websites you open, just do this homework and go home, and when you open, just type iHospital and open all the websites. I promise you, 9 out of 10 have the same image of a white lady who was probably in a dermatology magazine and who does not look like she'll ever have any eye problems or has them. So it costs just 5 to 10,000 rupees, if you're lucky, cheaper wherever you are, to do a photo shoot. Get a professional photographer, invite 10 family friends of yours. I've done it on my website. 10 family friends of different age groups to represent your patients. Sometimes your patients are so nice, they'll also come for it. Do a photo shoot and use those images, and make sure you put at the bottom that these are copyrighted images and they are your property. It makes a world of a difference. If the patient, if someone has cataract and they click on your website and there's an old sweet lady who's an Indian or who looks like they are from your region, and regionality is also very important, because if you are in Delhi and you're posting someone who, you know, is in a South Indian sari, of course now it's so cosmopolitan that it doesn't matter, but to a certain degree regionality is something that the patient or prospective patient will kind of appeal to them and keep them on your website. That's the key, because trust me, they are not only opening your website. When they are researching you, they have opened 6 tabs of 6 different hospitals that they have heard of, and that's where you have to stand out, where you're being compared against 5 or 6 other hospitals in the same city. So if you don't stand out and they can't relate to it, you've been eliminated. You've lost a patient, basically. And the second point I wanted to make is that if I have been burnt my fingers 3 times with very bad website developers, I might ask Mukesh for his next. But now I've realized that if you don't want to work with a coder and you want to be able to update your thing, and you have a lot of things to update on a weekly basis, WordPress is a great hosting site and designing site. You don't need to know any coding. You can just enter all your data in and attach the images. I use it for my travel blog. I'm planning to move my clinic website also onto WordPress, because it's very, very easy to just do everything yourself. You don't need a coder. You don't need to call someone and say, "Arey, mera conference hai ye teen." Because coders also will latkao you for another 2-3 weeks, and especially if it's a relevant thing, like I'm doing a rally in 1 month, I need it on now, but the coder will say, "Oh, I can't do it now, I have too much," you know. So things like that, WordPress is something that you should also look into. If you have the time to do it yourself, it's fairly easy to do.